Hi, everyone. I'm Bob DeMaine. I'm principal cellist of the LA Phil and a faculty member of the Impulse New Music Festival.
Woo!
Woo! And I am in the director, well, one of the director's homes here, performing six of the finalists, or the winners of the, yeah, the composition competition, which is really fantastic. I mean, every piece, every individual piece has its own special, unique voice. And I mean, I can get into a lot of things. I will say that much of this is a work in progress for me. So it might not be the Bible version yet. But I am going to perform all of these pieces. It's nice addition to the repertoire, the canon for modern music in general. So without further ado, I would like to start with the three shorts for solo cello by Emily Heemstra. I think that's how you say your name. I think that's a Frisian surname. Yeah, I bet you're from Michigan too, but I would never. There are a lot of straws in Western Michigan. Anyway, so it's three movements. First one is a barn dance, and the second movement is called Dolce and Dolore. The third movement is called Old Sport. I'd love to know the inside joke on that, but I recognize the humor with which you write this music and also the depth, and I'm really pleased to sort of play it for you. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. Bravo, Emily. Very enjoyable to play. You clearly know how to write for the cello. It's a beautiful piece. I love this like little fun suite of dances. It's just wonderful, wonderful stuff. The next piece on the program today, I'm going to attempt Akari Kubura's Elapsed, which she wrote in 2020. It says here, for solo cello and fixed media electronics. I have this nice little Bluetooth speaker next to me. And I have a little note that I can share with you. Elapsed is a duet for solo cello with the fixed media electronics, which overlays a pre-recorded audio of the same piece played in reverse. This results in a palindrome-like structure where the two parts are moving across each other in time. The midpoint of the piece unfolds into a powerful unison moment for both the live performer and the track as they sonically mirror each other in reflection. The work explores various timbres of the solo instrument, which emerge in conversation with the transformed timbres of the same musical materials in the reverse track. Elapsed centers around the idea of sonic memory, misremembering, and reemergence of the past, and challenges to listen to the time that flows in two directions sonically. Let's hope I don't misremember some of the details here. So, wonderful stuff. So, we'll get started. Thank you. my abilities are being really stretched right now. It's not just physically on the instrument technically, but just intellectually. It's like you got to study a legend of cymbals and all this stuff, and I haven't quite made it me yet, but it's on its way. I really love playing these things. Congratulations Miss Kumura, Miss Akari Kumura. Wonderful, wonderful. Just, I don't know where to begin. I mean, just, anyway. So I need a minute to prepare the tuning of my instrument, the next piece by Darcy Copeland, Bleuet Aporia, Bleuet 1. I guess she's writing a set of these pieces for solo cello. Well, this one is for solo cello and there for various instruments. Reminds me of how Debussy was set out to write six sonatas, and he only completed three, I think, the cello sonata being one of them. And so there's some interesting extended techniques, and you've never heard a cello played like this before. In fact, I haven't either. So if you give me a minute, maybe...
Yeah, so we'll mute the audio. This would be a great time to grab another glass of wine or something to eat real quick, and we'll just... You need like 2 or 3 minutes or so?
That's right. Hit the pipe, you know, whatever you need to do.
And then we'll bring the audio back on about 30 seconds or so before we start again. We'll
give
you about 30 seconds.
Sounds good. So I'm going to be off.
You'll be muted for a few minutes so you can tune. Yeah.
Oh, they're going to see me. Hi, everybody. We're back for part three of the first half of the program. Darcy Copeland's Bleuet number one, Aporia. And she has written a nice description of the piece, and she it's basically a bittersweet tribute to melancholia. Aporia can be defined as a logical impasse, contradiction, and expression of doubt. In philosophy, an aporia, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, references a state of puzzlement to be unable to proceed. In this first piece in the series, Aporia, I explore the contradictory experience of depression, of feeling simultaneously as though one could vanish into air, yet also feeling as though one's bones were made into lead. While existing in these contradictions, one finds oneself at an impasse within the subliminality of existence and non-existence, unable to fully be present in either plane. Much of the material presents itself on the precipice of existence and explores sonic emptiness in various ways. Other material drags as though weighted and revels in its own dullness. Moving between these extremes and melting them into one another, I attempt to sonically navigate the nature of this aporetic experience. Now it's my turn to attempt. And Darcy, if you're listening, this is a work in progress, so you may see things, you may hear things that you don't see. But I think I have the broad strokes. And especially I like the revels in its own dullness, because I feel like I'm reveling in my own dullness. I'll try not to be too dull. So anyway, this is a real knuckle buster. And one interesting feature is that you expect a cello to be tuned A, D, G, C. Not here. D sharp, D, F sharp, C. So, yeah. Aporia by Darcy Copeland. know if that was close to your vision of what this particular aporia is about, but I think I might be in the ballpark. I mean, there's so much sound in there that evokes the deepest, darkest, I mean, impulses in human nature. I love how we're not afraid to explore the darkness of what just happened with us and what is, you know, it's ongoing. But when we were in the depths of the lockdowns and everything, I mean, we had a lot of time to think on things. And it's an easy time to almost go crazy. So I'm so happy that people were industrious and created things like this during that time. So it's inspiring. Thank you, Darcy. I hope that I didn't offend you with my playing at all. So, bravo to Darcy. So we're going to take a little break.
We'll be back at 8 o'clock on the dot.
8 o'clock. Okay, sounds good. I'm going to retune my cello and let Mr. Viome recover. Thanks for nothing, Darcy. Just kidding. All right, we'll be back. Hello, everybody. We're back. Cello's happy. And next up is Emma Tucker's suite for cello called Luna. And you can't find enough superlatives to say. It's just, it's wonderful.
We've
pleasure to
dim
play.
Dim the lights for effect here.
Yeah, that's right. So the specific movements, the short movements of the suite are called New Moon. Number two is Waxing Crescent. Number three is First Quarter. Number four is, now I'm not sure how to pronounce this word, Waxing, is it Gibbous or Gibbous? Somebody will chime in. I think it's Gibbous, like a gibbon, but it's not a given. Let's see. So the fifth movement is called Full Moon. Sixth movement is Waning Gibbous, however you say that. Seventh movement is Third Quarter. Eighth movement is Waning Crescent, and then there is a brief epilogue. And most of them are played sort of attacca. But the textures are quite different in each one, so you should be able to recognize when I change movements. So this is Luna by Emma Tucker.
Thank you. Thank you.
captivating piece. I'll learn it properly. Again, everybody, if you're just tuning in, I'm sort of midway in the process of learning these pieces. So, great, wonderful. Let's keep going. We have Angela Elizabeth Slater, a piece that she wrote for apparently a friend of hers, written for Sarah Gate, Woven Half Dreams. And I believe it's in one, it's like one long tone poem. And very evocative stuff. So I'm just trying to see if there's anything to. We can read just a little bit about it.
Yeah, that's actually, okay. Angela is one of our composers this year. And she received a scholarship to come, so she's part of our cohort for the 2021 festival.
And she's in Britain, right? I think
so, in the UK, yeah.
Okay, yeah, so. So Woven Half Dreams is the second piece in the Connected Skies collection of solo pieces. All the pieces are reflective of the difficult times of 2020, drawing on a poem authored by Angela Elizabeth Slater as well. Woven Half Dreams explores unfurling threads and lines that are interrupted by bursts of aggressive, energetic passages. These aggressive bursts take more and more prominence until they push the weaving lines completely away through the center of the piece before returning to the weaving lines through delicate harmonic threads to the end of the piece, if the cellist plays in tune. Just get that. So the poem, Angela's poem, we really should read it. When the sky enclosed around me, shrinking ever smaller, I found woven half dreams fractured in spaces in between, which ache and scream. I tried to shut the noise out, but it echoed right back at me, never to leave or fully be. Although, I apologize for not doing it complete justice. It's really a tremendous piece. Extremely captivating. I mean, it's very connected, you know? There's nothing mechanical about it. I mean, there's some mechanical things I need to work out, obviously, but hey, I went for it. But it's a piece that, you know, you don't really have to sell that hard. Mm-hmm. I mean, it speaks for itself. It's in that category. So congratulations. I mean, all of you. I mean, everything, like I said at the beginning, each one of you has a unique personality, and that's why you got picked. I mean, yeah. So, you know, out of a pretty big lot. And so, anyway, congratulations. It's just, Angela, you really, you did it. I'm definitely going to be playing this and all these other pieces soon. So, we move to our last piece.
Yeah.
It is by a composer named Aya Yoshida, written in 2020, I believe, for a festival somewhere in Scandinavia, I believe. She writes, the description of the piece, it's not much to really say. The piece says everything. Be prepared. It's a roller coaster. It involves some extra musical things that I have to do, like I did sort of in the Copeland. But you'll hear some breathing and an occasional exclamation. Those are in the music. So I believe that Aya has written almost like this, like a chamber opera without words for solo cello. And it's extremely evocative, and it's hard not to get all stirred up when I even describe it, so I'm gonna just stop. Although, I do wanna say, she writes, the beauty of everyday things for cello solo. Duration, 16 minutes. And this piece is also dedicated to my friend who took the last breath this year. Buckle up. One other thing, it's in three distinct movements, so a little kind of like a sonata form in a way, but there's a first movement, second movement, and third. It's kind of a recapitulation in a coda. So. Thank you.
Thank you. Wow, that stirs up a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, I really think that's a great work. I mean, I can do better, but you know, can't we all? So except for the six of you, you wrote masterpieces. Wonderful. So congratulations. I wish we had time to like interact and, you know, talk about stuff. But maybe that can happen at some point.
Yeah, we can coordinate that, absolutely.
And they can tell me how wrongly I played their music. But you know, learning this and like, I mean, and working on it, it's really stretched everything, like musically, intellectually, physically on the instrument. It's just mind-blowing how, you know, learning your repertoire, especially at my age, is kind of like it can be a chore.
Yeah.
Because I'm always busy doing other stuff, and I always say, oh, I want to learn this. I have to learn everything kind of on the fly. But all these pieces deserve like greater attention. So they will get that. But and you can leave any questions that you have, I think, in the comments section if
that's
you like.
We'll see if we can coordinate a way to have some communication, maybe some sort of like forum, informal chat later in the week or something. So
I'm sure we could do that.
But I, if you're listening, I am very moved by your music here, and I don't know, your voice is it's very special. So just want to congratulate you, and I'm gonna be playing this a lot. I haven't paid my SAG dues. I think I need coaching with the acting, but you know, gotta sell it. Anyway, thank you for coming to the concert and enduring my playing, and I hope to see you all, meet you all at some point, and keep playing your music, keep writing masterpieces. Congratulations. Bravissima. Or is it Bravissimex? Do you say that?